Okay, says we're live. So I've got two boys in the background here, and they better be quiet. Hi, Dorothy. Hi, Pink Cut. We'll give some time here and let people come in. Let me check my other channel and see. It's working.
David Allen Coe.
So, I'm trying a new thing where I'm going to see if I can watch on YouTube and stream on StreamYard on the same computer. I'm not sure that it's doable, but we're going to give it a shot. Right now, it's just buffering, buffering. Don't think it's going to work. All right. There it is. Okay. Anyway, I'll say hi. Hi, Lane. Hi, Mindy. Hi, Donna. Hi, Eileen. About time. Hello. I was right at noon because these guys were in here bugging the whatever out of me. And so I waited until right at noon and then said, it's time for you guys to shut up or get lost. Fortunately, they got lost. Hi, Kimberly. Hey, Julie. Dabbler. So my plan for today is pretty loose. Don't know for sure what the hell I'm doing. Hi, Gina. Hi, Joy. So we got people streaming in. That's a good thing. Don't know who Paul is. Paul is Kimberly557's husband. At least that's one Paul that I know. Hi, Dabbler. I don't know if I said hi. Nancy. Hi, Lena. So we'll just give it another couple minutes. Hope you guys had a nice Easter. Hi, Joan. Hi, Brooke. Focus, you freak. Hey, Ange. We had a nice Easter. It was Robert's birthday. So I hadn't slept the night before because we'd had storms bad all night long and hadn't slept much. And so in the morning, I laid down and took a nap most of the morning. And then I got up and cooked us a nice meal, made some deviled eggs, and yeah, so we had a pretty nice day. It was pretty chill, pretty quiet all weekend. And today's a pretty nice day. It's chilly. We got down to almost freezing last night. I don't think it froze, so my little apple tree should be fine. I will give Sweet Robert a smooch, a birthday smooch from Eileen. Hi, Dee Dee. This chat just jumps, and I think I miss a whole bunch. Hi, Devin. Yeah, a birthday to Robert is just another day. He could care less. I didn't make a cake. I was going to bake him some cookies, but I'll do that one day this week because I haven't been buying him the cookies he likes, so I'll make him some. He likes my homemade ones better, so maybe tomorrow. We'll see. Hi, Janice. Anybody else? This chat is like jumping ahead a bunch of people, so I hope I'm not missing a whole bunch. So anyway, we probably got enough here. I'm going to give you guys a lecture again, okay? I feel like we need a lecture, and I like to lecture anyway, but in all seriousness. I had something this last week that really, I don't know, what's the word, dismayed me. So that's why I feel like I have to lecture. You know, streamers give a lot of themselves. There's a lot of time doing giveaways. Oh, no, a lecture, yes. Project planning, whatever. And one thing I would say is if you're fortunate enough, one, to attend a live stream and get involved in a giveaway or something like that, at the very least, so show some human decency and say thank you. I think it's just common decency. I think it's the least you can do. And I'm not asking for a lot, but really, if somebody's gone to the time and trouble to plan a whole project and do a nice giveaway for you, make a point of acknowledging what they've done and saying thank you and that you appreciate it. And that's the end of the lecture. I could go on and on and on because I was angry, and poor Dee Dee, I owe Dee Dee just like you wouldn't believe, because when I need to vent, Dee Dee's on the phone. And she talked me down off the ledge. And so that's all I've got to say. So thank a streamer. Thank them for what they give you, for the gifts they give you, whatever. Say thank you. It's the least you can do. Hi, Jan. Now we're both moving on to bigger and better things. So this week, one day, I don't remember what day it was, I did get a package from our Xandra. And Xandra's so sweet, honestly. She's got to be the sweetest person on the planet. You're welcome, Cheryl, and thank you. Thank you, Brooke. Just be mindful, I guess, is the best I can say. So I had ordered from Z a bunch of this Tim Holtz stuff. I said I would never do it again, but here I am, so what the hell. But I wanted this. I was going to do this for my April folder. And it didn't come in time, and I'd already created another one. So I'm going to maybe use this for my May one, or maybe not. I don't know. I'm kind of liking the file folder. But if you haven't seen these, I'm sure most of you have. It's just a little cardboard folder that you can turn into kind of like a traveler's notebook. And then it's got this handy-dandy little thing that you can glue stuff on. So I don't know if Z just ordered me one. If she's, thank you, Ange. Back out just a bit. Okay, thanks, Dee Dee. I wasn't paying any attention at all. Anyway, yeah, these are fun little things. I don't know if Z's going to carry them, if she just ordered one for me. But yeah, so I got my little Tim Holtz folder. It's really cute. I mean, I'd like to use this as a template for one and decorate my own. So I think I might do that. I might just use this as a template. And so I can decorate my own, but it's a cool little thing and they're pretty inexpensive. And then I did buy the fabric tape. I don't know why I don't need any more tape, you guys. I really don't. I just don't, but I bought it anyway. And then I did buy this cool 3D texture fades embossing folder. I have not used it yet, but it's like the steel plate. I don't know why. I just thought that was really cool. So I'm gonna have to try that pretty quick. I also ordered these Tim Holtz mini stencils, and I've already used these. You get the mermaid scale. It looks like unwoven gauze, and then the circle. And it was the circle one that got me, and mostly because it's mini. Any, I'm all over it. But I did really, really like these, and I used the Thinnabar wax to them, and so now they smell so good. So I would say anytime you get a new stencil, put thin wax on it, because yeah, they'll smell good forever. I have to use this, the embossing folder with aluminum foil. I just used my last aluminum foil yesterday. I might have more though, because I'm kind of a hoarder. Yeah, so I thought they were pretty cool stencils. And then the only other thing I ordered was, and I don't know why, I could draw every one of these things, but I just saw it and thought, oh, I like that. And I don't know, let's see, it's Studio Light. By Art by Marlene, and It's all the art supplies. I could draw every one of them, you guys, but now I just have them on rice paper. So that, and then Z, because she is just such a sweetheart, sent a bunch of extras, which she does in every order, I think. Just some little ephemera, her business card, which I must have 1,000 of these by now. I should tell her, Z, you don't have to send me these anymore because I save everyone. And I'm not sure why I have to save everyone, but I do. And then the little sugar skull girl that she drew that's so awesome. A mermaid tail that she made with her little thank Z. And then just ephemera. So that'll probably be going in the beast. And then she sent me these two napkins, which this one I've already used part of it. And you'll see that in a minute. And then the clock one. I kind of feel like I should put this in an envelope for Dee Dee, though. I don't feel right having a clock one. That should be Dee Dee's, I'm pretty sure. So first time I get a envelope of stuff going to Dee Dee, my guess is that will be hers. And then that's the little tissue that she sent it in. So I haven't ordered anything forever. So that was fun to get. It was almost just like Christmas for me, because really I've been so good about not ordering, you guys. I have been so good. Is getting a box from Z is just always fun. Oh, you have one? Keep it? Okay. So I'll have to use it on a Dee Dee page then. Robert brought me an iced coffee from Sonic this morning, so I appreciate that. I'll be so caffeined up here in an hour, I'll be zooming through whatever. Because I don't do caffeine. Sandra is so kind, isn't she? And if you guys ever met her in person, hey, CB. She is really one of the most lovable creatures on the planet. I cherish the time that we spent in Australia together, along with CB. I mean, I cherish it because of both of them. Yeah, it's just, we were so lucky to have been able to do that. And then I was going to work on my, oh, before I do that, I got to do this for Eileen. Eileen, you wanted me to do something with vellum paper. I got out my vellum. This top is not vellum. This is scrap vellum that I had. What do you want me to do with vellum? Hi, Danimo. Happy Monday back at you. Use the clock napkin for an Eileen page. Her yelling about time. I know. That's what I could do, Lena. That's a great idea. Hi, Kathy Bird. So I'm waiting for Eileen to tell me what I'm supposed to be doing with this vellum, because something came up at Dee Dee's about vellum. I love vellum, by the way. It's kind of hard to art on. Like, you can't watercolor on it. It has almost zero absorbency. But for stamping and colored pencil, vellum is awesome. Awesome. Eileen's not around. Oh, you fold it for you. Okay. Well, if you fold like Dee Dee, which that was a great tip Dee Dee gave this morning. She was showing that match up your corners over here and then fold from the middle. This might not even be cut straight. There. Start in the middle and go one way and then go the other way. And I didn't get any creases. One of the things that can happen with vellum is it will get little creases. But no, it folds beautifully. Really, really nice. We'll fold it in fourths if my hands will work. Yeah, no creases or anything. So vellum is awesome paper. Vellum cues and fountain pens. Yeah, fountain pens work well on it. The problem is that the ink sits on top. It does not crack. I think you got to be a little careful. It probably could crack. This particular vellum did not. And then Shelly, or Shell, in Dee Dee's stream was asking about fountain pens, and if your fountain pens are the ink's not flowing readily in your fountain pen, the very first thing I would do before I scrap the pen is I would take the entire thing apart, take the ink out, take everything out, and clean it really good. You've probably got a little bit of ink dried somewhere that's preventing the ink from flowing freely. That's what I would do first. If it continues to do that, I'm not sure that there's a whole hell of a lot of help you can do for that. But when you take apart your fountain pens, unscrew this part of it and soak it in, take your ink out, soak this entire thing in warm water with mild detergent and let it soak. And then after that, rinse it real good and blow through this end until you get bubbles coming out down here, and put ink in it immediately, dry it off real good, and you should not have any trouble with your pen. Mild detergent and water is not going to hurt it. Most inks are water soluble. And if you have let an ink pen dry up and then just think you're going to put ink back in it and get it to write, it's not going to work well ever. So clean your pens. I have an ultrasonic cleaner, and if you have access to one, that's the best thing, because it'll use sound bubbles to break up whatever dried ink is in there. But if you're not going to use your pens, go ahead and clean them out. Don't let the ink dry in them, because you're just asking for trouble if you do that. There's Shelly. No, it was a different show. Hi, Shelly. So that's my advice on fountain pens. I'm not exactly an expert about it, but I have a lot of experience and I know what not to do. But I have the advantage of having an ultrasonic cleaner, so there's really nothing I can't fix usually. And this is the folder we worked on last week, and I love it very, very much. I really do. I like everything about it, the colors, the theme, the everything. So I'm going to put this in. This is the other part of that napkin that Z sent me. I went ahead and used just a quarter of it so that I can make a, I got too much junk here, a little pocket for the corner so I can shove junk in it. So I was going to do that. This is the painting I did paint along with Kathy Arbor on Thursday. You have 20 pens that need to be cleaned. Yeah, Eileen, thanks. I love it too. Take all 20 of them apart, Gina, and throw them in some warm, with mild detergent, or just like a drop of Dawn. Dawn is the best for everything. Yeah, I did do the houses along with Kathy Arbor. I find her incredibly inspiring. I really do. And so this was her house, Xandra's house, and my house. And it's funny because I don't know if I posted pictures in my house, but she was just put me on an island, and she surprisingly knew a lot about us. And I think if any one of us sat down and wrote down all the different things we know about the Fibs just from hanging out together, we'd probably be shocked at how much we actually know about each other, because she had my house. You know, I know I've said that it's a barn-shaped house. She had things about me and my house that were surprisingly accurate. I was just like, oh my God, you got it so right. So this is, in fact, a cartoonish drawing of my house. This is the back of the house. Here's the lakeside. I put the emu on there, and Robert said, that's not an emu. Its neck's not long enough. Dumbass. So, yeah, and I tried to do the drawing and everything as quickly as I could, right along with Cass. And she had like a mermaid coming off of Z's. And but then I got so far behind that I just went ahead and made up my own after that. So, but this was really fun. And I wanted to do some more of these just because I think I'll be shocked of how much I know about all the fibs, you know? And it was fun to do. You know, these, when you're working along with somebody on a stream, you're having to move fast. Like, I had to draw this all out real fast and then paint real fast. And you never know what you're going to end up with. But the thing is, it's going to, if it's not good, throw it away. Who cares? It's an emu. Yeah, that's the emu. And he's right. The neck should be longer. But I did post on Instagram a picture of the emu's face from talking that day. But there's little mistakes and things that I could have done better. But, oh, it was so much fun. This was so much fun. So if you get an opportunity or you have, you know, an inclination, paint along. It was so much fun. What are the rents like in that neighborhood? In this neighborhood, if you get Kathy, me, and Xandra as a neighborhood, the rent should be just through the roof. Like, nobody could afford to live there, right? Because you'd have such great neighbors. Hey, Mark. That was the emu's happy face, Devin. He was being a bad ass. So, yeah. So that'll go in my folder. And then the, I didn't do this on stream. Yeah, I just did this by myself one afternoon. This was really fun. It was challenging. This paper, this caddy paper is, it's nice paper, but it's kind of hard to work on. And I did this with the Arteza paints. So I think you can get some really, really good results with the Arteza paints. Oh, Julie, you can come for an extended stay anytime you want. You are always welcome. And I'll try and feed you good and drink you good. Yeah. So that's all I've got ready for my folder for this month. And we're almost halfway through the month. That's pitiful, isn't it? Yeah, I like the Bird of Paradise. I really did. Yeah. I like the, you know, because I don't even know that I have my own style because I'm generally working off of somebody else's original, you know, just so I can learn, you know, choosing color, mixing, whatever. And I probably learn more from my mistakes than I do from my success. But one thing I know I do like is I do like the ink watercolor mixture. I really do. Like coming back and putting all the detail in here with the Zig Clean Color watercolors and then ink afterward. That this was so satisfying. So, yeah, I'm thinking that is definitely going to be my choice. And so this one, I just want it to match the folder. So I re-wetted the ink crystal or the walnut ink crystals, and I'm going to go ahead and paint that on real quick. I got to get a caca brush. And then we'll let that dry and I'll insert it in the book. I didn't do it earlier because I had to let it dry. And I did use the that glue that Eileen made me buy. What's it called? I don't know. Starch paste or whatever the hell you call it. Oops. Don't need the. I'm just going to brown this up and then ink the edges. So I don't know how the. This may not work considering I used, what's that paste called, Eileen? It might just sit on top, so I might have to get out some actual ink. I probably will. I wasn't sure if this would work or not. I might be happier if I use the ink. But that was just too stark white. Did you use the alt walnut ink crystals on the folder? It seems, yeah, I did. I dissolved them in water, Kathy, and I'm pretty sure that's what I used. And so it was still sitting here, but it had dried out. So I just added a little bit more water to it. I think I wanted a little darker. But one thing I like about it is where the napkins get creases, the walnut color kind of sits there. And so you see all the texture, which I really, really like. But yeah, we did. We used the ink crystals on there. Rice paper paste slash glue. Yeah. And it's got a name. Let me see. It's right there. I can't believe I can't remember it. Yamamoto. This paste. So now you'll see how liquid works on it. I don't think it's going to work as well as I might like. But who knows? And it doesn't have to be as dark as that other one. And then what did I use to ink the edges? I can't remember. I'd have to go back and watch my own video, which I'm really not excited about doing. You know what I mean? All right, let me hit this with a heat gun. See if I can dry it up. And then I might use some other ink on it. I think a little bit darker than it looks right now. But what do? We threw magicals on there. We threw the ink crystals. We did white dilutions paint. We threw just about everything on it. Yeah, I want it darker. I'm going to go ahead and use some a stamp pad. Another thing I did this weekend, Amy and Lane brought me an iced coffee. I think it was Saturday morning. And because I'm not used to caffeine, got me all caffeined up. I literally washed every cupboard in my kitchen, like the outsides, well, outsides and insides, the doors. Washed the kitchen floor. I went cuckoo. That's what caffeine does to me. I went absolutely cuckoo on Saturday. And then Sunday I couldn't move. All right. Since this is just sitting here, I think this is brown. It's going to be now. Yeah, this is going to work better, I think. And because it's just sitting on top of this, I might have to spray this with a fixative so that every time I touch it, it doesn't just wipe right off on my hands or whatever it's touching. This is permanent. It's archival. I don't know who makes it. I've had this for years, 100 years. But I thought this napkin was so pretty, I had to use it immediately. And it reminded me of spring. Spring can't get here soon enough for me. Not that I'm going to do anything different than I do any other time, though, except I'll work outside more. So Amy sent me a picture last night of a succulent. You guys have seen plants like this. I'd never seen one this color. Let me show it. So you can do booze to sober up from the caffeine. That's probably what I'm going to have to do. Drink booze to put myself to sleep after I caffeine myself to death. Okay. She sent me this picture, and you guys have seen succulents like that, but I've never seen a pink one, a pink red one. I've seen the real soft green, and the colors are not showing up well on screen. But she said, I think you need to paint this. And I said, well, I think so too. So I did go ahead this morning while Dee Dee was streaming and draw it out. So there's my, can you guys see that? There's the drawing. I did it real light of the little succulent. And this color is going to be really, really tricky. That's the one thing that's kind of got me stumped is, oh my gosh, that color. And so as I was thinking about what color am I going to do it, I got thinking maybe it would be fun to do it in a shimmery, because the plant itself looks kind of shimmery, right? So I thought, why not get out the Paul Reubens, because I hardly ever have used these. I love them. I love the paints. I love their packaging. I like everything about Paul Reuben. So I thought there's got to be a color in here that would work and make it a kind of shimmery succulent. What do you guys think? Or my other choice, because I've already got it drawn out. I did it, I think Friday, I don't remember, is to do this iris. I've painted these kind of iris. I don't know, when I look back, it was like four different times. I've done different versions of this type of iris. Dutch iris, I think they call it, or something like that. So I've never seen a pink one either. And then I wrote her back and I said, "What? Like, is that yours?" And she said, no, she found it somewhere else. But I was like, well, good, because now I won't have to break in your house and steal it. Of course, Amy's so sweet that if I said, oh, Amy, I love that plant, next thing I know, her husband would be bringing it to my door, because that's the way she is. So either one or both, I don't know, whichever we want to do. Can you guys be thinking about it? Eileen's going, well, I'm going to take a nap now. Yeah, that looks more like it belongs now. And I'm just going to run a line of glue on it, leave it. Oh, I need some darker around the edges. You know what? Around the edges, I use that thin paste. I'm going to use that thin paste again. Both, Defo, the flag iris, Sheltren. Yep, nap time. You don't want to go take a nap, Eileen. You want to hang out with us. You just acting all bad and stuff. Which did I use? Did I use the bronze on that? See, now I don't even remember. I think I did use the bronze. We're going to use the bronze again. Now the whole folder is going to smell delicious again. Look for my little brush in here. All right, that's two or three different things I've gotten out now, Eileen. So it's going to be messy. Would Brooke say? Pink succulent. She is a party pooper, isn't she, Kathy? You kill all indoor plants. I don't have any inside my house, but I do out in the breezeway and in the greenhouse. Of course, I haven't been out to the greenhouse. Those out there are probably dead. So, yeah. I love this wax. I just love it. And otherwise, I didn't do anything arty all weekend. I maybe worked in the Beast a little bit Friday night. Saturday, I clean like a maniac. But I kind of like when I get in those moods. I turned on, do you guys like Mike Rowe? I love Mike Rowe. And so I turned on his podcast the way I heard it, because there'd been a few episodes here recently that I had missed, that I forgot that I like listening to him. So I listened to Mike Rowe the way I heard it while I cleaned. And it was just like hours passed, and I didn't even realize that the time was passing. But I like his voice. I just like Mike Rowe. And his mom's got a new book out, so I'm going to be ordering that too. Yeah, Dee Dee likes Mike Rowe too. I love Mike Rowe. The new Paul Harvey. All right. Now I'm just going to run a glue line and get that done. So this is just really a little bit of housekeeping. But you guys can watch as the folder evolves. I need to do art to get in it. That's the problem. And I'm just going to use Eileen's tacky to glue it in. Use some paper clips or something to hold it in place until it dries. He's hilarious. The one when his mom lost her blue wallet. Oh my God, the blue purse in the parking lot. That was hysterical. Big Blue, isn't that what they called it? Big Blue was his mother's purse. Jeez, what pig has been messing around with this? Oh, that was another thing. That reminds me. As part of my kitchen cleaning craziness, I also cleaned through all of my cigar boxes and repaired the labels. So that's what the pig who left that mess was me when I was working on my cigar boxes. I'll trim it after it's glued down. Oh yeah, check Mike Rowe out. He's the guy who did Dirty Jobs. I'm sure you've heard of him, Devin. He did Dirty Jobs, and he is the narrator for Deadliest Catch. But I think I first started watching him with Dirty Jobs. This is just a little container that I keep a little bit of everything in. And these will just hold it in place while I go on and do other stuff. And by the time we're done here, it should be glued pretty good. Lena sent me that. Yeah, he narrates Deadliest Catch. He's got such a beautiful voice, and something most people don't know about Mike Rowe, maybe some people do, but he was, when he was very young, he was an opera singer. He has the most beautiful voice, singing voice. And he does, he has a foundation called Micro Works, where he's trying to, I don't know, tell kids that there are tons of jobs out there that you don't need a four-year degree for. Kind of like vo-tech jobs, welding, that sort of thing. And he gives out scholarships. He's really a philanthropist. He's just an all-around good guy. I mean, that's one of the reasons I love him, is he's a good, good guy. I'm a fan. And I love his parents. And he does, he has a Facebook page. What's it called? Give it. Oh, now I wish I could remember the name of it, but where he goes around and surprises what he calls bloody do-gooders. People do a lot for their community. Oh, he does love his mama. Yes, he does. And who wouldn't love his mama? Andrea Bocelli is putting out YouTube concerts. I hadn't heard that. There's a lot going out in the world on a rat, you know, everywhere in the world. I got to wash that one. All right. So we got that done. We'll move on to bigger and better things. I think I'm going to do the succulent first. I actually could be working on both of these projects at once. So when one's drying, I'll switch over and work on the other one. How's that? And this one, I don't have a cheat sheet for this. I can't believe I don't have a cheat sheet for these colors. So I'm going to have to do some testing before I can choose a color. The paper for this is Color It. I learned about this paper from Shauna, and she said she liked it. And she is kind of a perfectionist about her watercolor papers and stuff like that. So this is neutral pH, durable heavyweight surface, excellent for a variety of watercoloring techniques and wet media. So it doesn't say that it's cotton fiber. It does say acid free. So yeah, it's an inexpensive version of watercolor. So I've tried it a few times. So I decided today I would use that paper. I'm always trying to find an alternate watercolor paper because I can't find the B paper. And that Ultratech or whatever they put out, Amazon used in its place, that is some serious junk. I don't like it at all. So I think the base of this plant is going to be one of these shimmery pinks. If not, I'll go over and use, I think it's called Duotech. One of these, this Hibiscus Duo, I think is the paint that I thought until I got decided, oh no, we can use the Paul Reubens. And I know a lot of you have the Paul Reubens. I can't remember who first showed it. Oh, that one's pretty. I can't remember who first showed us the Paul Reuben. It might have been Z. These re-wet beautifully. That one's not it. This one I think is a little bit too orange. Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. And I'm working off of a photo, so that might be a little hard. No, so far it's that the real pink one. That orange is sure gorgeous, though. Now I need to do a cheat sheet for these. I think we're going to go with that one. And then for the dark in the center, I think I'm actually going to use one of the M. Graham's or Daniel Smith colors. Let's see which one. Alizarin Crimson, probably a real light shade of it is probably what I'll do in the center. But I'll start the entire plant with a wash of, I think this first one I did. So that's how we're going to start it. We're just going to wash the whole plant in that light pink and hope to God it comes out halfway decent. If it doesn't, it's water and paper and a little bit of paint. And I don't generally like to, the really good watercolor people tell you do not go directly from your paint to your paper. I do sometimes, but I'm going to go ahead and mix it here, clean this little mess out. And I know people who are protective of their brushes are saying, don't do that to your brush. It's a brush. If I have to replace it, I'll replace it. How about that? I can't go around worrying about everything. I'm quarantined. I can't worry about anything. Are Paul Reubens good? I've been putting off because I don't know much about them. Dabbler, this is the only set of Paul Reubens that I've got.
And I'd have to say it's been months and months since I've actually used them. But yes, they re-wet beautifully. This is the shimmer set. But then they also make, well, Paul Reuben actually makes a lot of different products. They make watercolor journals, regular paints. I don't know where to put them in the value category. This was kind of an impulse buy after I saw, I'm sure it was Zandra, talk about the paints and the packaging. It was back when we were all buying every freaking watercolor out there. But I would say, based on what little bit I've used them, yes, I like them. You know who can tell you more? Ask Lena. Lena has more sets than I do. That would be cool on black paper. Yeah, I actually painted on them on black paper, Devin. They are really nice. On black paper. Yep. The shimmer is not going to show so much on the white, but I think because of that kind of whiteness of the leaves, I'm not sure how I'm going to capture that. So I'm going to try and do it with the shimmer and then add the white and the darker on top of it. I could be approaching this completely wrong, you guys. I don't know. I could be approaching this totally, totally crazily. And I'm going to go ahead and wet the piece of art itself and do like wet on wet. And then let it dry completely. I'm going to lift up some of this because I'm not sure I want the graphite showing that much. And then I'll decide later if I want to go back in with some ink. I don't want it so light that I lose it, but yeah. All right, here we go. So Eileen has now gone to sleep. Or she's sitting there eating Milano cookies with her cats. And if this comes out good, I'll probably send it home with Amy's husband and paint myself another one to go in the folder. And the drawing's not exact, but it's close enough that you get the idea, right? The drawing took literally 5 minutes. Don't be afraid of doing your own drawings. Nobody's going to look at it and say, oh, that's not exact. But I'm glad I'm using my shimmery paints. This paper is sucking up the water a lot, which cellulose paper has a tendency to do that. So you kind of got to work a little bit fast. Hopefully this is going to be light enough. Yep. And don't take your watercolor instruction from me, because really, I play, and more often than not, I dumb into a decent result. And I know I'm slow because I probably don't know as much as I should know. But I'm learning, and I'm okay with it. But when you're stuck indoors like this, everybody needs a hobby. That's one thing I would tell people. If you learn anything from this quarantine, get a hobby. Like, you don't think other people entertaining you is your hobby. I've said that for many years prior to this quarantine. And I'm not sure. It won't look good until I get the shadows and stuff in. So right now, I'll pull you guys down because everything's so light. You're probably not seeing it that great. All right, here's Lena. I favor Paul Reuben paper and watercolors. Grab them very often. In my honest opinion, they are at the high end of student grade and behaves very nicely in mix and brightness when dry. Okay, now I would say I trust Lena and her evaluation of any of it. So, hi, Jilly. So yeah, if that's Lena's recommendation, now I'm going to want the other Paul Reuben paints, but I've got so many others. Right now I'm just smoothing out some of the areas. We're going to set that aside and let it dry, and I'll get the paints ready for the other painting because I will take them out and put them in a palette. I didn't on that one because I'm only going to use one or two colors, so I didn't see the point in doing it. But this I will put out on a palette. And this book is Watercolor Flowers, Painters A to Z. Adeline Fletcher. Don't know where I got it. Have no clue where I got it. I like it. I'll flip through it real quick. It's different than the book I showed last week. I'll just lift the camera up and we'll flip through. Oh, I should know I need to turn that off. Yeah, that helped the color a little bit. Sorry, I forgot. So, beautiful paintings. They always usually put their gallery toward the back. Like that, I think, is gorgeous. This one I have bookmarked. I love Calla Lily. I like the... this is not necessarily monochromatic, but it has a very monochromatic feel to it. And I love this. There you go, Lena. If you don't have a hobby, get good binoculars and really get to know your neighbors. There you go. That's Chinese Wisteria. Violet Pansy. I have this one bookmarked at some point. I think that would be a good learning experience. Tulip, one of those, what do they call them? Fiery tulip or something like that. Nasturtium. I've painted some nasturtium before. Lilac. This one, I probably should make myself do something like this because it would be such a different technique than what I'm used to. So yeah, I think something like that would be good. This is a different bird of paradise than the one I did, but I like it too. Rambler rose, rhododendron, primrose, petunia. I love petunias. Geranium. I don't like this. This is a passion flower. I don't particularly care for it. Poppy, love poppies. Peony. Oh, by the way, update on peony bush. Robert sat here yesterday and told me, oh, your peony bush came back. He said, I mowed it down. I mowed it down. It's coming back a second time. I was just like, you idiot. You idiot. You have the guts to sit there and tell me that. I said, don't mow it down again. I said, I won't get flowers this year because you already mowed those down. But let the plant at least grow a little bit so I know where it is and I can at least get it transplanted. So the peony bush is coming back faster than Robert can mow it down. Water lily. He is so funny. Here's daffodil. My daffodils have bloomed and they're already gone. There's blue poppy, magnolia. I love magnolias. Stargazer lily. That's probably what Dee Dee's going to have in her yard because she planted 60 bulbs. Sweet pea. Loves sweet peas. Red hot poker, iris. Of course, I love iris. Morning glory. I have morning glories all over the place. Shell, I did talk about pens and taking care of pens at the beginning of the stream. So, and it's not too far in, probably in the first 10, 15 minutes. So you can go back. But it's pretty much what I told you before. Wash them out. Hydrangea. We have lots of hydrangea down here. Spanish bluebell. amaryllis, Syrian rose, Lenten rose. I've never seen one of those, but that's also very monochromatic. I think it could be pretty. Sunflower, love them. Gladiolas, I love them. Snowdrop, freesia. This is one of the freesias that I painted. I have painted this. Poinsettia, sea holly, they're ugly. Coneflower, used to grow those in Boulder. Carnation, delphinium, dahlia. I love old-fashioned dahlias. They're some of my favorite orchids. Kathy Arbor grows the most gorgeous orchids anywhere. Cyclamen, they're pretty. Clematis, camellia, angel's trumpet, begonia. That would be, I want to paint this. I should put a bookmark in there. Columbine, that's a state flower of Colorado. Only theirs is the blue columbine, but columbines come in a lot of different colors. Anemone, African lily, and then just all of them, and then some little bit of instruction at the beginning. So there you go. That's the book I'm working out of. Your husband whacked down your tomato plant? Oh, that would be death around here. But I grow tomatoes in pots, so he can't get near it with his weed whacker or his mower. But tomatoes are really nothing but weeds, you guys. Tomatoes are easy to grow. If you want tomato plants, take a tomato from your kitchen that's, you know, maybe too old to eat or something. Just put it in a pot. Just put it in a pot. You will have tomatoes. They are nothing more than weeds, I promise you. So this is what I'm going to do next. And they give you all the colors over here. I don't have all the colors that they recommend. So I just come as close as I can with the colors that I do have. I'm not going to order a bunch of flowers. I'm just going to use what I've got because I have plenty. If I don't have it, I don't need it. How about that? All right. So new gamboge, which is kind of an orangish yellow. I'm going to add some lighter yellow to it. I do have gamboge in a different, in the Arteza paints, but I'm just going to mix these because I'm using M. Graham today. Expensive paints on cheap paper. How's that? Okay. Permanent rose. I don't know if I have permanent rose in this. I have rose matter in Daniel Smith. I don't even know where they're wanting you to use that. I don't see it on there. I'm not going to put it out. If I need it later, I'll get it. Dioxazine violet, which probably this is going to be as close as I'm going to get. I'll have to water it down a lot. Cat hair's in there. I always love that. French ultramarine, which is kind of a purplish blue. I don't have French ultramarine. So I'm going to try and make my own. How's that? Got a little bit of purple and then ultramarine. That's one thing about doing watercolor. I'm much more apt to mix my own now than I ever would have done before. So I think in that respect, it's been good. What kind of wax did you use on the edge of the pocket? Oh, Carol, that's, I think you're, you might want to hit live and catch up, but I used the Finnebear wax, Art Alchemy, in bronze. I'm sure you can get this a lot of places, but if you go to Paint and Paper Studio, Xandra carries it in her shop, and it is absolutely delicious stuff. So let me see if I need some additional purple in there. No, that's a beautiful color. Wow. I'm going to remember that mixture. That was awesome. Okay. Some cobalt blue, which I do have. Cobalt blue deep, I think, is what I'm going to use. And I can make these darker or lighter as I need. Right now, I'm kind of mixing them medium. Cobalt turquoise. I'm looking at my cheat sheet over here. I don't have cobalt turquoise either, but it's kind of a bluish green. I think I'm going to do I have phthalo green blue. I think I'm going to use that because it's really, really pretty. But I'm going to use it real, real light because it can be, that's a funny color. It can be almost knock your eyeballs out bright. So let me see if I really do like that. It's going to have to be lighter than that. I'm going to add some green to it. What green? Probably a little bit of permanent next to it. Just green it up a little bit. Yeah, that's better.
Get out of here. Go over to Barb's. Any of you, don't feel bad. If you want to go over to Barb's doing mandalas, get out of here. I don't get my all bent out of shape if somebody streams on top of me.
It's just like, you could be watching Mari Povich on the TV.
Get after, go make yourself happy. I'm not going to get all upset about that, okay? Just not me.
All right, and now the phthalo green is really more like a Kelly green. I'm not sure I like any of these greens, but we'll just use a lighter version, real light version of that. All right. I'm almost done here. Sap green. I do have sap green. Sap green is one of my very favorite greens. Not that I want you guys to leave. That was kind of rude the way I said that. I love for you to be here, but really, if there's another channel on that you would enjoy watching, don't worry about hurting my feelings. I'm going to be sitting here painting no matter what, so
it's all good. Got it? You'll never get used to Amber working from home. I imagine that's a huge adjustment for a lot of people. Robert and I spend all day, every day together. Him being under my feet all the time is just pretty much normal for me. But I imagine people who don't spend all day, every day together, that this is quite an adjustment. And you're going to find out how much you really like your spouse. Robert and I can spend all day, every day together. Not that we're together all day, but we're pretty much together all day. Doesn't bother either one of us, but we're both. I'm going to say this and then people in chat are going to laugh, but there you go, Ange. That's that would be an idea, wouldn't it? Hi, Z. I showed all your stuff, Z. But yeah, you'll find out whether or not you like your spouse. But Robert and I, we're both so easy to get along with. I mean, honestly, we are. In the 20 years that I've been with Robert Vaughn, I can only think of one time ever that we've even come close to having a disagreement. For one thing, we don't have anything to disagree about. He does his thing, I do my thing, and we get along great. But yeah, I imagine people are just sitting around going, why the hell did I marry this monkey?
All right. Those are our colors for this. I'm going to call it a Dutch iris. I know it probably has a different name. So those are our colors. Let's get painting. When I start a new something, I'm always a little bit excited and a little bit apprehensive. And then about halfway through, usually I go through a period where I'm just like, oh my God, you bit off way more than you can chew, stupid. You should never have done that. And then in the end, I end up going, okay, it's not that bad. So I think with watercolor or any other kind of art you do kind of have to work through the uglies. And it's no different than any other, you know, you do it in art journaling pages or anything else. You know, there comes a point about midway where you just go, oh God, this is horrible. Work through the uglies. You'll be glad you did. All right. I don't know that I'm going to be able to, I'll just periodically show you what my goal is. That is my goal. Okay. And I'm going to keep it over here to the side and I'll pull you guys down where you can kind of see more what I'm doing. I'm not sure if I should shut. Let me try shutting that shade real quick. That'll put me in the dark, but oh well, we'll see. See if that helps you guys. I'm not sure if it does. I think I'd rather have the light. How about that? All right, we're going to start generally, and I don't know if this is a rule in watercolor, but I generally start with the lightest colors and then put the darker ones over it because, yeah, you can't go back. So I think that's kind of a rule. I need my cheat paper so I can kind of see. I do want this kind of a rich, rich yellow, so I'm not going to dilute it any further. Oh, before I start, I want to pick up a little bit of my graphite lines. Watching and baking. That's a good thing, Jilly. I'm going to be baking. I think tomorrow, I think I am going to make Robert Bond some cookies. And this is just graphite that I'm lifting up. I probably should have, and I always forget until it's too late, I probably should have drawn this with my water-soluble pencils. So I wouldn't have to pick it up. All I could do is just paint over it and it goes away. But I didn't think of it in time. And I drew this, I think, Friday. I was going to paint on Friday, and then I don't know. Got sidetracked or something. All right. That'll help a little bit. All right, here we go. I'm not going to wet everything first. Well, you know what? I might wet part of it, so that I can get some darks and lights where I'm going to put the yellow. And I think this is really just a matter of preference, how you want the paint to act. You know, I could just as easily have done this wet on dry, but I do want the yellow to be dark in places and light in others. And this is an easy way to accomplish that. Put the paint where you want it darkest and then work it down into areas where you want it light. And the purple should go over that just fine. And you can always go back and add more colors, which is a good thing. Now I want that yellow to go right down to that other petal. So darkest on the outside and let it seep down. And the paper is going to affect how the paint spreads. That's the absolute truth. Well, both the paint and the paper affect how it spreads. So I think you just kind of gotta learn to work with what you've got. And that one didn't stay wet. And that's the crap paper, but that's okay. I'll make it do what I want. I should have gotten a rag out. That's not as dark as I'm going to want it to be, so I'll add some more later, but I'm going to go ahead. I didn't draw much detail here in the center, so I'm just going to kind of make it up as I go along. I figured it was going to be easier to do it. As I painted. So there's a little bit of yellow, not very dark in here. And I like to let the watercolor dry naturally. And on stream, that's really hard. You know, because you got people sitting here waiting. But like a lot of times if I'm watercoloring, I'll get this part done, get up and walk away and let it dry and then come back. But I think what I'm going to do right now is go ahead and do the green because it's not anywhere near the yellow. And I'm not really paying attention to the instructions. At this point, I'm kind of just winging it. I'll do it by color. All right. It looks like she has a lot of yellow in her stems. So I think I'm going to go ahead and put the yellow in there and then go over it with the green and mix it on the paper rather than mixing it in the palette. And I'll do it in sections because it's easier with this inexpensive paper. This actually is Grumbacher paper that I drew this on. Not the cheapest paper around, but definitely not Arches. So I hope you guys are staying busy and finding things you enjoy to do. This is no different than my normal life, so it hasn't been painful for me, but I know for a lot of people it probably has been. I think more than anything, it's an idea in your head that you can't do something. That's more bothersome than actually not being able to do it. You know, like, you're not going to tell me that I can't do something. And I'll add more color. I missed that part. And I'm not rinsing my brush real, real good. I think where's my little cheat sheet? All right. I'll separate these later. Right now, I just want to get color on more than anything. It's always kind of the first thing in watercolor is just get your color on first.
I love when you talk out loud about your different choices.
It's a different thing to do, isn't it, Lena? Because when I'm sitting here alone, I'm probably just talking out what I'm thinking in my head, even when I'm alone. You know, I have to decide, okay, do I want to mix this color on the palette or do I want to do it on the paper? So now I'm doing out loud what I would do if I was alone. And I know if you have more experience, you probably don't have to ask those questions of yourself anymore. But because I'm so new to it, I'm still having to ask myself virtually every move I make, what would be the best approach? And I hope the day comes where I don't have to do that, where I just kind of know intuitively what the best approach is, but I'm just not there yet. But I know it's like anything else that you're learning. If you do it long enough, you'll get it figured out. And that's one of the reasons I think doing it with Kathy Arbor is so good, because you don't have time to second guess yourself. You don't have time to think, you know, you just have to do it. And then after you've done it, it's just like, well, that worked. Okay. And I forgot one of the, when I was drawing, I didn't put in that little leaf up there. So I'm going to go ahead and just sketch it in real quick. Favorite pencil right here. Graph Gear 3-point. The lead is a little testy. Is it maybe a good word for it? It's definitely testy when you have to add new lead, but great, great, great pencil. My yellow got a little dirty, and that's fine. I don't think I'm going to need pure yellow anymore. Your flower paintings that you posted, Lena, were amazing. And I agree with you that painting the stuff around the jars and stuff can almost be better than painting your original subject. I should do more glass sometime soon. The marbles and stuff were really fun. I love those. And I was always surprised at how well they turned out. All watercolor artists talk to themselves, even the famous experience one. Oh, good, Jilly. So you're saying I'm not first in line for the nut house? Wouldn't surprise me if I was. After all, I do hang out with a rat all day, every day. So all I've done here is pretty much get the same base coat down for all the leaves. But when I'm done by adding the different greens, I will end up hopefully with some depth that won't appear right now. And I think that is just something you learn as you're doing art. Kind of like Dee Dee when she paints in her backgrounds first and then comes back. And then all of a sudden the depth starts appearing out of nowhere and it looks like magic. Yeah, that's kind of, we're at the background stage right now. All right. All right, I think that's all the green. My yellow is pretty dry.
So I love it when a plan is coming together. It does make you happy and in a spring mood to paint flowers. It does.
I like flowers no matter time of year, though, either. All right. Should I hit this with a heat gun? I think I'm going to quickly put this aside and let that green dry naturally. Wash out my brush real, real good. Get the yellow and greens out of it before I switch back to this succulent. We're changing gears. This is going to be a real test, isn't it? I'll pull you guys down close so you can see. All right. Bring back up the picture that Amy sent me. Hopefully my battery doesn't go dead. All right, I'm going to go ahead at this point and put in the dark part of the center. And actually, we get another little palette here. I must have 1,000 palettes in this drawer by now. There's a clean one. Because I want to use alizarin crimson. Oops, just banged the camera. yeah, I think I want to use a real light shade of the alizarin crimson. That's Quinn Violet. This is alizarin crimson. So I'm taking this out of the M. Graham. Now I'm going to add water to it to make it real light. Yep, I think that's going to be dark enough. Should be. All right. So I'm not sure how I'm going about this, but we're going to do it whether we like it or not. Okay, right there is the center of the flower. And I hope I don't lose my pencil marks because this could get pretty hairy here. So right in here is the absolute darkest. And on around back here. And I'll define all that with shadow later. Now I'm going to go ahead and put the darkest on each of these leaves. And honestly, you guys, I don't know if this is the best approach or not, but it's for me, it's the easiest to see where I want to make the shades and just define it all better later, because most of it's going to stay that light pink, I think. Yep. Doesn't look like much right now, does it? I hope that improves. I might have to get a little bit darker on the alizarin in some places too. Okay, now this one. I'm doing this. I'm really watching the my original art, because some of this I'm going to have to do with grays and other colors. Because it's really not red. It, you know, your brain wants you to think it's red, but it's really not. It's gray. Suppose I can cover a lot of the red with the gray. Now I'm going to mix some little bit lighter. Oh, I forgot the dark one. That's okay. I'll get it in a minute. This is quite a challenge for me, actually. And I'm sure somebody else would do it completely different, you guys. This is lack of experience that you're watching here.
I'll check chat real quick. Yeah, an excuse to hit Amazon. Watercolor pencils, my favorite. Watercolor pencils, honestly, are Statler. I love the Statler. But if you want ink ones, get ink tents.
All right, let's see. I'll darken some of these now. Check in. This definitely I wanted red. Okay, and to soften, I'm going to go back in with some of the original pink. I'm pretty sure it was this one that we used. Yep, it was. This is looking awfully, awfully pink right now. It will start getting depth, I promise. If it doesn't, it's going in the trash. It's good for me to have to do stuff like this, though. I have to totally decide on my own. Okay, what are you going to do there? Like there, I hate that line. I think that when you do the very last thing and add the white, the highlights, that's when everything just pops. But these out here are lighter than those over there. This one is probably the lightest one of all. All right, need a little bit of the dark red on this one. Not that dark. I hate for Lena to even be watching me do this. She'd have it done an hour ago. And I think for the gray in here, I'm going to do a real, real light Payne's gray. And when I say light, I mean light. That one isn't even on the picture. I just added that because I could, I guess. That one's pretty dark, but it's gonna, I want more red out here. All right, we're gonna let this one dry for a minute, and then I'm gonna get the gray out, and we're gonna start building some depth in here, because that's all white. This one, I probably need a little bit more pink, I think.
Thanks, Devin. No, I struggle big time right now. I'm drawing a checkerboard floor and wish I had your ruler skills. You want me to get the ruler out and show you, Lena? I'd be much more comfortable there.
All right, I'm going to have to plug this phone in. I know it's going to die because it was already low. All right. Back to our iris. This one's looking pretty good. I'm happy with it so far. Let me move the paints. Okay, there's our reference. I think I want to do, just to get the base down, I think I'm going to do the light blue next. And I'm not following their instructions, so I'm just going to wing it. And then this I know is the purple. Yep. So I've only really got the two blues. And I'm going to have to do the blue and the purple, I guess, all really together. But I'm going to do the lightest blue first. And right now I'm going to go ahead and wet the paper. And then add the blue to it. And I'll just do that as I go. Ooh, that's dark. And I'll do just a section at a time, because mostly if I was working on a better paper, I would probably do more at a time. But because this paper is really kind of crap, I mean, it's better than some, but because it is kind of crap, I'm going to go ahead and just do sections at a time. So I'm adding the second blue in here and just letting them mix. And whatever they do, I'm going to be okay with. And the nice thing about flowers is they're all different. So if mine doesn't look like the original, that's okay. It's just a different flower, you know? And watercolor always dries lighter then it appears on the paper. So even though this appears kind of dark, it's going to dry lighter. Right now, it's almost like that blue is resisting any other blue to touching it. Lightest sections first, and then I'll come back in. And mix the blues and the purples. And hopefully that's when it will get really, really fun. Watercolors in some ways is almost like magicals, especially if you're doing wet on wet. Like you put it down and then add another color to it, and it just, you get something you don't expect, at least when you're a novice. It's like, oh, that's way cool. I didn't expect that to happen. All right, this whole leaf here is almost white, actually. Or petal, it's not a leaf. Petal is almost white, so I'm gonna try and be really careful here. And this is the darker of the blues. All right, and before this dries, I'm going to go ahead and add some of the other blue in there, just a little bit here and there. But I'm also going to, before it dries, because I don't know how many times I'm going to come back in here, I'm going to add just a little tiny bit of the purple. I mean, and I'm just going to say little tiny right here on the edges. And then you can't control it, so you just let it do whatever it's going to do. But it looks way cool. I'm going to pull you down real close so you can see. And then there's some purple. And then I'll add more. But I probably won't go back into there again. So and I know it's hard to see on camera, it really is. See that is touching that, so I'm not sure. I'll let that dry a little bit. I can do this one down here though while I'm waiting for the others to dry. And that's another thing about watercolor. You've got to really think about what's still wet, because anything you put next to it that touches, it's going to spread. And if you get too much, just pick it up and take it off. In some ways, watercolor is very forgiving, and then in other ways, it's just absolutely unforgiving. And you learn that as you make mistakes. And that's one thing I can say. Doing watercolor, I probably have learned more from my mistakes than I ever have my successes. Okay. And then I'm going to go ahead and do a quick wash down here. But I'm going to come back in and add more color. But I'm going to do a quick light wash so I can have some variegation, I guess, of color. But it's going to ultimately end up being a lot darker than I start out here. I'm going to go into the yellow a little bit, I think. Oh, I'm liking the way this looks already. Okay, and I'll go ahead and put the blue on this one. This one we'll come back to. It will be a lot deeper color than it appears right now, but I'm going to get the lights in first and then come back and add the darks. After it's dry, but I want the lights in there. Because the way I chose to do that, I probably at the end, I'm going to have to go back in and add white, and that's fine. I don't mind that. I suppose it's not a purist way to approach it, but it doesn't bother me. If I have to go back in and add detail with white or black later, no, I could care less. If I come out with a result that I like, I'm A-okay with it. But I know that some people, if you're a purist, that may be unacceptable. I don't really know. I'm not. I'm just lucky to get paint on the paper and be happy about it. And that's pretty much how I look at it. This is going to be mostly purple over here, but I'm just going to put this down. Because that's going to be a light purple. And that's going to be a dark purple. All right. And the last one. Yeah, this is, see how light it's drying? So now when I go back in over it, I can leave these light areas that I want. So my plan is coming together and it looks like I know what the hell I'm doing. And here's the truth of the matter. I don't freaking have a clue. Kind of like when I'm cooking some nights. I don't have a clue what I'm doing. I just figure if I don't poison us, it's a good day in America. No, I actually am a halfway decent cook. I don't know if my kids would agree, but they didn't starve either, and I didn't poison them to death. Now, let's see what color. Oh, that's light blue. I like that.
Kind of looks like a paint by number right now, right? Thanks, Lena. There's a lot more detail to it than you might think.
All right, right now there's really no place that I can probably go back and paint. Yeah, it's all still too wet, so I'm going to leave that. I'm going to let it dry real good. We'll go back and add some gray to this bad boy. There's the little thing. Where's the Payne's gray? I'm gonna start adding some light gray to this now. I don't remember which is up and down anymore. Which one is it? That's neutral tint. Payne's gray. Here we go. Okay, I'm going to mix it really, really, really light. And I'm guessing at the Payne's gray, you guys, I really don't know. But I want it really, really, really light. Can you guys see my cheat sheet up here? I would recommend before you put anything on your paper, do it on a cheat sheet and let it dry so you get an idea of what you're going to end up with. Go from your lightest to your darkest. Thanks, Nanimo. Oh my God, Ian's here. Ian, look away. Cover your eyes. Go put your mask on. Ian and Lena being here make me a little nervous. They're both so good at what they do. They make me look like, what the hell are you doing, girl? All right, I'm going to quickly, let's see. That's pretty light. I don't want it any darker for that than that. That's for sure. All right, let's go here. Is this my up and down, or did I get this turned around? I think I got this turned around. Maybe not. Have any of you tried Karen markers? I have not. I don't need any more markers. Ugh. This weekend when I was cleaning, I cleaned out all my cigar boxes and I washed the stamp cabinet and everything. And I was thinking, you know what? One stream, I should just get out all my stamps and show you guys. Because literally some of them, you guys, I started collecting my first stamp when I was like 14. So some of the stamps I have around here are 50 years old. And I'm sure I have stamps that you guys have literally never seen before, ever. And then I thought, well, if I'm going to do that, probably what I ought to do is do a sale at the same time. Start selling them to you guys. But yeah, I have stamps that are so, so, so old. And I love them all so much. I mean, I tease about getting rid of them all the time that, oh my God, they take up so much room and blah, 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 blah. But I do love them. I love my stamps, even though I don't use them much anymore. I love them so much. And I love the ones my mom left me, you know. But I don't use them much anymore. Not like I used to.
Don't you just get rid of?
Devin, those were all newer stamps. They were all acrylic. I got rid of some of my acrylic. Yes, I did. Those I don't have any kind of attachment to, could care less about them. I buy them for the purpose of using them, but they have no real sentimental value or any value at all, really. You can buy them anywhere, anytime. Of course, I didn't pay anything for them. I do have this upside down. No wonder it doesn't look right to me. Okay, now I'm feeling better. Okay, now I can see exactly. I'm struggling, going, now that doesn't look right. That shape is not right. Well, it wasn't right. I'm not sure how to give it that iridescent look either, but we're either going to figure it out or we're not.
Red rubber and polymer stamps are my weakness, along with everything else. Yeah, see, I like the
rubber ones far, far better than I'm still my. Where's that little one? Okay, there's that's because that okay. I'm losing my mind. Yeah, I like the red rubber. And plus, I think without any doubt, the red rubber stamps better. And they last better, in my opinion, than the acrylic. Not to say I haven't bought plenty of my share of acrylics. But I don't have any problem getting rid of them at all. They can go. And I don't even know, do they even sell the collectible stamps anymore? Used to be you could buy collectible stamps. I don't even know if they sell them anymore. I'm going to add some real dark in here. I'm going to have to start getting some of the real dark. That may have been a little too dark. But the nice thing is, watercolor, you can pick it up if you work quick. Okay. All right, I can start seeing a little bit more definition here. go ahead and add some dark, real dark, I think, to this center here now. In this dark out here, I could go back and do it at the end with gray pens or black pens too. And I may do that because I know I'm going to add the white at the end. Amy, you've given me quite a little challenge here, girl. Okay, so this is the shadow. Around here. Sometimes setting it aside and coming back later and looking at it gives you a whole different idea of what you're actually, what it actually looks like. Like right now, I can start seeing that it's getting a little bit of depth, but it's painstaking, right? There's my battery going. Oh, that should be redder. That's why it doesn't look right. Okay. I'm gonna have to get a charger and get it plugged in over here. I do like this shimmery paint for this plant, though, I have to say. Now, hopefully that parts of it will dry lighter. If not, I'll go over it with some of the shimmery pink again. But I think I've got most of the biggest shadows, I think.
Sorry, I'm not talking. It's all Lena's fault.
Thanks, Lena. Well, it's odd that it would be Lena's fault because most of the time, honestly, it's all Eileen's fault. Okay, I'm going to just do a little experiment here because I want to see how something's going to work. Like on the center part, it's not just a flat red. It's shades of red, right? But the way I've got it painted, it looks pretty flat. I'm going to try to add some of the shimmery color on top of it. It's better than I thought it was going to be. But yeah, let me try and see how the two paints are going to behave together. Of course, this is wet on wet. I should let it dry first. But I do want, and I'm not quite sure, technique. Now, this is where experience would definitely help. And I don't know if you guys can see it on the camera. It's not a carnation. It's actually a succulent, CB. Can you, I don't know, I don't think you guys can see it in the picture, but there's like in the center here where it's real, real dark, like you guys can see the dark, I know that, but where it's real, real dark, there's almost like a, I don't know if you call it luminescent, I'm not sure what to call it. And because of my lack of experience, I'm not sure how to achieve that. And I know putting light over dark is not probably going to work, but I'm wondering if the shimmer won't help some. That's the thing I'm wondering. My phone is saying, enough already. Duh, I know that. Oh, okay. Sorry, CB. I don't know who's been here and who hasn't, so I'm going to add a little bit of shimmer. It won't hurt anything if it doesn't. Yeah, my phone just went off, so it's saying enough already. Poor phone. I do that to it all the time because I'm going to go over probably all of it with a real light wash at the end to kind of mix in. But the shadow on the bottom part is much, much darker than the shadow over here just because of the where the light is hitting it. You've been here since the start. Well, that's what I thought, CB. Let me grab my phone charger and plug it in, which means I won't have a heat gun, but that's okay. And I don't have a huge amount of time left, so I'm going to go back to the iris, and I'll struggle with this later. So now I know what I'll be doing the rest of the afternoon. Sitting here struggling with the watercolor. Hang on, plugging in my phone. Too much devices, not enough plugs. Does anybody else feel like that? I feel like that all the time. I'm having to plug a phone in here, plug a tablet in there. Moving from one place to another. Yep, too much devices, not enough plugs. You like the shading? Yeah, I'm okay with the shading. And let's see, I'll try and pull the picture back up. And when you see it with the light, like you can see the shimmer a little bit. But it's not like in your face. Come on, phone. There we go. I don't know if that's going to focus you freak or not. I think when I go back and add some white, I think it's going to be okay. Does that look even remotely like it? Oh, you guys talking about Eileen? That she's probably napping with one eye?
Okay, CB.
Sometimes it's hard for me to tell. Is this coming along at all, or am I just sitting here wasting mine and everybody else's time? See, right there, it's going to be a bright white, but there, okay, I got that little bit of gray there. Experiment here. I'm putting some more of the pink down. The white, I'm not sure if I'm going to use like my white pen or if I'll use gouache. I haven't hardly used that gouache that we bought. Well, my niece, I didn't buy it. My niece actually sent it to me. This actually, the whole petal is in shade. So I need to just go ahead, dilute that down just a hair. But yeah, I haven't hardly used those at all. I don't know if it's a little bit of intimidation or what. Well, I think part of it is sometimes when you get too much stuff all at once, you don't know what to play with first. And I think that's where I'm at with the gouache. I got so much stuff that week that it was like, oh, I didn't even know what to play with first. And I think that's kind of what happened with that. So I need to get those out. Maybe I will do it with gouache. What did I do with my rag? There it is. Got to get that moved before it dries. That is probably the darkest, other than there in the center. That's the darkest right in there. And I'm going to have to just bite the bullet and go for the darkest at some point. I don't like taking it directly out of the tray. I'm going to darken that up too. And maybe next Monday, because I had so much fun playing with Kathy Arbor, maybe next Monday I'll do more fib houses, because I thought of some really funny things to do for Eileen. Thanks, Elaine. You would frame it and hang it up? No, I'm not sure if I'd go that far. But it is starting, I'm starting to feel the depth. So that's kind of the thing that, how I determine what kind of job I did. See, that's going to be real white in there. You got to think ahead. That one is pretty darn good. I'm happy with it. This one needs a little bit darker, I think. Now I'm just fiddling, you know, like making sure this looks like this. Does this look like it should? Nort that out a little bit, and I'm going to add some of the pink. Where's the pink? Okay, need some shadow in here. Because in here it's real, real dark. Okay. All right, that feels a little better. I don't know if anybody else does it, but I go back and I check my original drawing shapes to see. And that's probably just too damn much perfectionist, you know? Like, did I keep my shapes the same? White. All right, and then there's a little tiny bit of real dark right in here.
Eileen's house needs a flagpole with a green thong as her flag. That would be hysterical, Lena. You need to do that on your show. Just make that a regular strip joint pole instead of a regular flagpole. Yep.
Or a whole clothesline full of nothing but men's thongs. That would be Eileen's. And Kathy actually did the flamingo out in her yard, because that was one of the things I thought, is that she needs like flamingos out in her yard for sure. And Kathy got that. Kathy's was excellent. All right, I'm going to quit fiddling with this, because I could actually fiddle with this like the rest of the day. And this got to be boring as hell. But I will go ahead and darken up some of the shadows. Like that one's coming down. This one is just, this whole petal is just not right. Just not right at all. And I know that. It needs more red, is I think what the problem is. Because it actually is kind of red iridescent all the way down. Like with one real dark red there and then more red coming up here. Maybe that's what I needed. Same with that one. Because you can see the front and the back of that, like this one as well. This one as well. That's what I wasn't getting right, is that you can see the red going down the petal. That better dry a little bit lighter than it is. I might pick some of that up until I know for sure. Yeah. That bee's better. And then at the very end, I'll go back in and put the darkest reds. And the blacks. Sweet. Okay, you guys, I'm getting happier with this now.
You're actually using paint today, Ange. I feel like a proud mama right now.
That makes me think of Jamie. I said something similar to him the other night. He sends me some of the raunchiest stuff. whether it could be anything, really. And then he gets on a roll. And honestly, sometimes when he gets so gross and nasty and raunchy, I just couldn't be more proud. I'm just like, there's the boy I raised. He's just so raunchy. But honestly, that boy makes me laugh more than probably any other person on earth. I have the funniest kid in the world. And this quarantine, it is bringing out the best in him. When he was young, some mornings I could hardly wait to get up in the morning because he would leave me notes and I'd get up in the morning and I'd never know what I was going to find, what note I would find from Jamie. And I found those not too long ago. I saved them because they were just so awesome. But yeah, he's quite a boy. I wish he'd come down so he would stream with me. But I'm not even sure if I could let him on the air with me. You guys would just go, oh my God, what kind of kid did you raise? That center needs to be pinker or redder. I don't know. And I'm not sure I'm happy with my coloring right now. It's fairly good. You know, the gray pink is I think, kind of what I needed, but there's something missing and I've got to figure it out. So I'm going to put this one aside and we'll work on the date or the daisy. The iris a little bit more. And you guys can tell me, do you want me to go ahead and finish this off air? Or do you want me to hold on and come back and work on it when you guys can watch? Because there's probably another, I'm guessing, hour at least to be done on this iris, if I'm lucky. The I'll finish both of them on stream. Oh, he is a cool kid. He is an absolute cool kid. And the nice thing is, and I hope each of you have it with your own kids, but like, he's not afraid to say anything to me. There's absolutely nothing that's off limits with Jamie and me. Absolutely no topic, whether it's politics, sex, drugs, rock and roll, doesn't matter. We can just pretty much talk about anything. There's no words that are off limits. And so I think you get a good idea of what you've raised. And I have to say, I'm pretty proud of that boy. Not only is he smart, talented, has a good job, but I'm proud that, you know, of all the people on earth that I can just talk to flat out, it's Jamie. And I think that's what you want with your kids. But yeah, he sends me funny stuff. I like getting up in the morning, not knowing what I'm going to get in my message box from Jamie. He's absolutely hysterical. All right. So that, I like that blue. This is looking good up here. Just looking at what we want to do, because I think I'm at the point right now where I want to start adding some purple. Let's do this one first because, yeah, it's right in the center where if I wreck anything, it's going to be right dead center. That's what I'm all about. I'm going to add some of the blue first, and I probably am going to have to mix some more of the blue, but that's fine. Because I want more of a blue purple, and I hope my purple hasn't dried enough where it's too dark. It probably has. I'm going to lighten it a little, I think. Let's do cheat sheet and see what kind of purple we got before we slap it on the painting. All right. We can always darken it. Hopefully we'll start seeing some really nice depth here soon. It's looking pretty flat right now. I'm mixing a little bit more purple. Don't charge extra for the cat hairs, man. That damn cat. Lane was up here the other day and we were talking about the age of my cat. Because I don't want to leave her right now. Like, I would love for Robert and I to be, of course, not during the quarantine, but at some point for Robert and I to be able to leave home again. But honestly, with this old cat, I don't feel right leaving her, and I can't put somebody, of course she knows Lane, but I just can't leave her right now. She's just too old, you know, so I just feel like we're kind of stuck at home. So we started talking about how old she was. She's 18 years old, this cat. She might be older than that because I don't remember exactly. And we were looking up the cat age chart. This cat is over 100 years old in people years, I think it was what we decided. Because I think I got her in 2002. Right? Would that make her 18? Yeah, at least 18. But I'm not sure about 2002. It might have been sooner than that, earlier than that. So I'm stuck at home because of the cat. That needs to be yellow. All right. Clean out your paintbrush. Put the yellow in where it needs to be. But yeah, I think in people years, like this cat is a 100-year-old cat. I can't leave her. I don't know what got me talking about that. Except that I can't go anywhere because of the damn cat. Because I know Lane and Amy had come down and feed the cat, but you can't leave an old cat. She has a right to be cranky. She does. Putting up with me and Robert is enough to make her cranky. I can't paint in there now because I just got it wet again. So that has to wait until later. This one coming up doesn't really have much purple on it. I like the blooms. A lot of people don't like blooms in their work. I don't mind the blooms, you guys. Sometimes they give you the exact effect that you want. All right. Now this one comes down. And the purple is down here. And I want it dark purple. Maybe not that dark purple. Cool. I don't think there's really much other purple on there. So there's lots of purple down in here, though. And I'll come back in and put some stripes and dark and lights in here. Well, not lights. This is the lightest it's going to be after it dries one more time. But we're getting close to doing detail now. All right, and then this all over in here is also purple and about the same shade. So we're going to go ahead and put it in. Purple and yellow makes gray, makes mud. So, yeah. Unless you want mud, be a little careful. That actually is blue in there. All right, moving on. That might bloom up in there because I just put water on a dark or on a dry place, but that's okay. That won't bother me. I'm going to go ahead and get this wet down here so it starts running like crazy. All right, I need some more ultramarine. I'm pretty sure that was just straight ultramarine, that I hadn't mixed anything with it. This is when I really like watercolor, is when you can just start teasing the colors kind of where you want them. That's when I really, really like it. I probably should have gone dark up here on this one like I did on this one. Because that's about going to be the same values up in parts of this petal as well. And then I'll come in with the purple later. Of course, it's going to dry a little bit lighter than it appears here. Nuts, too damp. I can't do that now or I will really, really create blooms. But that's about where it's going to be. All right, the center here. It's kind of muddy, actually. What was that last color? Quinacridone gold. I guess that's kind of what the color is. We're going to use it. I can paint in here because it's not been wet before. Well, nope, because it's going to touch there. Never mind. Liar, liar, pants on fire. Do a little bit more blue down in here. I'm just adding some little bit darker purple now in just spots. And I can go ahead and add it to this one up here because this is dry enough now. So that's one thing watercolor has taught me, to be a little bit patient, because I have zero patience. I want things done and I want them now. Like, I don't want to wait. With watercolor, you have to learn to wait. Like, get up and walk away, come back to it later. It'll be there later. You know, that's been really, really hard, is learning to wait. Gotta be a little careful. That's still wet down in there. And don't put your hand, your arm in the wet paint. That's another lesson you have to learn. Oops. Just painted on my pants, which I don't care. All of my clothes are paint clothes. Right now it's awkward because there's wet there, and I have no place to put my hand. All right, and up in here, believe it or not, there's a little bit of green. Probably not that much green, but a little bit of green. So I'll take some of that out. Which is a weird place for green, but that's where it is. All right. All right. Yeah, this is dry enough now that I'm going to go ahead and put some of the darker blues and purples in. My time is almost up. But I will still, I didn't read chat if you guys want me to wait and finish this or just go ahead and finish it and post a picture. I know my inclination is to just go ahead and finish it. But since I've drug you guys along this far, if you want me to wait, I'll just put it aside and come back later. All right. Now I need some really, really dark purple right in there. I kind of like this style of painting, I have to say. I really do. If you're in the zone, keep going. That's probably a good plan, honestly. Because it's hard to get back, you know, and keep your colors and everything. Yeah, it's a little harder to come back to a painting, I think, after you've got more than half of it done. If I'd stopped right at the light shades, I'd come back to it anytime. But now that I'm into the other colors, yeah, you're probably right. Just keep going and get it done. All right, I hope that dries a little bit lighter. Okay, I like that one. This one I need some, and I mixed that blue. So which one did I use? I think it was cobalt. I'm gonna have to mix some more, so we're just gonna go for it. It was cobalt, I know that. That's the problem. If you have to go back and mix again, try and mix as much as you need the first time, because going back the second time, not that good. That's all right. It's not going to be near anything else anyway, so. Oh, you guys, I was trying to think what else I did this weekend. I watched the weirdest show on Netflix. It was called The Stranger. Has anybody watched that? That was the craziest, most bizarre show. I think there's only like 5 episodes to it. There might be more than that. It seemed like it took me forever because most of the time when I was watching it, honestly, I was in the absolute dark. I had no clue what was going on. And then the ending, oh my God, the ending just freaked me out. Freaked me out. So if you want like to spend an afternoon like in the dark, like in the total dark, watch The Stranger. Shelly watched it. Oh my God. I know, right? It was just like so many twists and turns. And you're like, you're in the dark just going, what the hell am I even watching? And then the end happens and you're just like, no way. I have to say the end was such a surprise. And I can't say if it was a good surprise or a bad surprise. You know, like I can't even determine if it was a good surprise. It was just more like a knock your socks off kind of surprise. Just like, no way. And I can't even really say with all certainty that I recommend it. Because I honestly, I was in the dark for so much of the whole show. But there, who's the actress that played the, it was a thriller for sure. The actress that played the female policeman, Safe on Netflix was the same. Okay, I might have to watch then. Because honestly, I was blown away in a good way though. I mean, it was just like, oh my God, no, I never saw that coming. So if you like those kind of shows, it was, yeah, it was totally cool. All right. So this, I'm going to go ahead and put a couple of the, what I call details in, so you guys can kind of see how it's going to work out in the end. And now I've got so much wet on here, there's almost no place that I can touch. Yeah, I guess I must like thrillers because I could not turn it off. I mean, I had to keep watching. I really like the colors in this. Too much water there. All right, let's look. Oh, the Quin Gold. That's what I was going to do next. So you could kind of see. Am I right here? Is that? Okay, yeah, I am. Hey, Lane. Everybody say hi to Lane. Church is meeting early today. Robert and Lane get together almost every day and have a beer. And we call it church. I am really liking this one. I'm liking it a lot. And I have to write that down, Safe, so I don't forget, because I'll forget where I heard it. Safe on Netflix. Don't have. I live in a house full of paper, and I never have anything to write on. What the hell is wrong with me? Okay, got myself a note. And my time is just about up. I'm going to rinse my paintbrush. Let me show you this compared to my original, and we'll see how close I came. I've still got quite a bit of detail left to go, but this has been fun. It's been fun for me. I'm not sure it's been fun for you guys, but oops, there goes mouse on the ground. There's the iris, and there's my original. So I'd say so far without the detail and adding some white back in, I'm feeling good about it. Yeah, I'm liking these colors. I'm liking these colors a lot. You know, and ultimately I will go back and do a really strong critique of it to see, you know, like, what could I have done better? What could I have changed? What, you know, but so far I think it's fairly accurate, you know, and I like when I can replicate something fairly accurately. So that's where I'm at on that one. And I'm enjoying the heck out of it. And then this one, which really has kind of thrown me, but I think when I get the white back on it, you know, add the white highlights and maybe darken some of the other shadows, I think. Okay, that's the way it goes. And I wish you guys could see this better. This one's not horrible. It definitely needs some more shading because it's looking a little flat to me. But I think I can fix it. A little bit more definition, shadows. I'll definitely post it. If you don't follow me on Instagram, that's where I post most all of my art. So let me tell you what my name is on Instagram. Oh my God, Kathy Arbor's flowers are so gorgeous. Okay, just look up Janet Merle. Janet Merle should do it. Let me go back to home. Look at Kathy Arbor's flowers. Oh my God, they're gorgeous. She already has flowers like that up in the barren north. Anyway, oh, there's some of my granddaughters. They're when they're really little. These girls are all grown now. But it's kind of fun to see their old Easter pictures. Their mother posted that. So, oh, good. I'm glad you guys enjoyed it. I really appreciate you hanging in. If anybody gave a thumbs up, thank you. Appreciate it so much. So thanks for coming. You're welcome. I like streaming for you guys. Be kind to each other. This is really a stressful time for everybody, so be kind. Eileen, I didn't even have to be mean to you today. I'm going to have to rectify that the next time. So go create something awesome, and just be kind. Say thank you. All right. Love you guys a ton. See you later. Bye. Come on, Anne.